greater responsibility. Vishnu.
Barkha, how would you compare or contrast what the Prime Minister said, the tone in which he spoke, with what Mr. Chidambaram said in Parliament, where I thought he was a lot more direct? He spoke more about Pakistan. He spoke more about the nature of evolving extremism in Jammu and Kashmir.
Not really, Vishnu. I actually saw the Prime Minister's statement as an extension of a possible shift in New Delhi's attitude, because while Mr. Chidambaram may have spoken about a change in Pakistan's strategy, Mr. Chidambaram also acknowledged that Kashmir was a unique problem that needed a unique solution. And that is at the highest level of government that we saw the first acknowledgement that there is genuine alienation among the people, among the next generation of Kashmiri youth. And I think I sense for the first time the fact that the media has brought to light stories of young men who believe that they do not have a single political leader that they can look up to, stories of young men and women who are willing to defy death, not just defy curfew, but even look death in the eye and come out on the streets. You're seeing now 8 to 9 year old children who have grown up only in an environment of violence and alienation and brutalization, if you will. And remember, what we saw today in that 2 minutes of silence was not just the Prime Minister. We also saw all of the key ministers of government, Pranab Mukherjee, A.K. Antony, the Home Minister, standing up in that 2 minute of silence, the Prime Minister speaking on behalf of the whole government. I would actually say that while we're seeing it late, and maybe much too late, and many people could ask why it took 2 months of silence for the Prime Minister to speak, I think this government has finally acknowledged, without any value judgment, there was no labeling of the protesters as stone pelters, there were no prefixes put, there was just an acceptance that we understand you're angry, we're willing to talk to you, please talk to us.
What about the opposition in Jammu and Kashmir and the fact that they've been reluctant to be part of the process in terms of meeting the Prime Minister, a joint political process? They would perhaps
will be meeting the Prime Minister separately, Vishnu. But the fact of the matter is that there is the need for a national consensus, not just a regional consensus, but a national consensus. The BJP has opposed virtually every proposal that has been brought up so far, whether it's the autonomy proposal of the National Conference or the self-rule proposal of the PDP. But that stands where it does, and the Prime Minister did speak for the need to create a workable consensus. The BJP has also opposed any amendments to the Armed Forces Special Powers Act. The Prime Minister was not categorical about that, but it's significant that in the presence of the Defence Minister A.K. Antony, he spoke.
और दो लोगों को निलंबित कर मामला प्रवर्तन
स्टेडियम में तो मीडिया की मनाही है ही, लेकिन सड़क
क्योंकि पूरे कोस्टल एरिया में इस तरह के कई सारे जहर फैलने के भी
मुंह पे कपड़ा बांधे हुए और गन वगैरह लिए हुए खड़े थे डकैत, तो उन सब ने अपना सर झुका लिया, बंदूकें भी अपना नीचे कर ली और खड़े रहे. करीब 10 मिनट हो गया, 15 मिनट. तो फिर मैंने पूछा कि मेरे पति कब आएंगे, कितनी देर लगेगी, तो उन्होंने कहा बस आ रहे होंगे बस.
Year old boy, I think you're seeing the Prime Minister and this government finally reaching out, trying to open a channel of communication with the young, disengaged generation, the lost generation of Jammu and Kashmir.
In fact, that entire issue of Kashmir's lost generation is something that Barkha will be looking at very